sit nice and straight. Actually scooping all the way back on your chair. And then so you feel your sacrum fully on the back, and then you can lean back and relax your hands and your feet on the floor. And your eyes are softly closed. And let's focus now also on relaxing your bottom jaw and the tongue. Even if it creates a little gap between your lips, it's fine. Feel that relaxation on the jaw. And it's curious, but sometimes this little detail, when it's absent, the relaxation doesn't really happen, full relaxation. So when we relax the jaw and the tongue, we actually get to complete, to take our relaxation to completion. It also helps us align the neck a little better. And let us drop our arms beside the chair. Turn the palms out. And before we lift the arms, just feel your shoulder blades on the back of your chair. Now that you've turned your palms out, you want to be able to feel your shoulder blades even on the chair. And the chest is open. And in this pose, we're going to take a profound breathing in. Hold for an instant and out. And again, let's take a profound one in. Hold your breath and squeeze the root of your body, the perineum, the sex organs, squeeze there. And let go. And for the next inhale, we are going to send our arms up. Reach them above your head and then dive forward and down on the deep and generous exhalation. And then straighten yourself, restart your spine. Let the chin come up forward the last. Turn your palms again out. Inhale and send your arms above your head. Feel that stretch on your back and your armpits. And then dive forward, rounding the back. Explore how low you can go, still feeling comfortable. And then restack your spine. Last time, return those palms out, reach your arms above your head. And this time, instead of diving forward, we'll exhale, bending to one side. We start challenging our balance here. We're shifting the weight to one side. Inhale, straight up. Exhale, bend to the other side. And again, inhale, come up. Let's get those palms touching each other. And as you exhale, bring them to your heart. And let us open our eyes here. Good. So palms are together. Let's start by shaking those fingers back and forward. And just take a little second to feel what is joining you in this palms movement in your body. Like shake, you can close your eyes or keep them open and just feel. What in your body is participating through the vibration maybe or a real movement that you could say, oh, look, doing this.
Shoulders.
The shoulders, absolutely, yeah. I would think you would say, you know, the closest part, yeah, the elbows, but yeah, the shoulders too. Excellent. And then we're going to point those fingers down and the shoulders will go down. And let's move the elbows like wings. And we try to have the contact with our body, I don't know, the edge of your palms maybe, the edge of the wrists. And you want to move those wings here in a very awkward way. I haven't seen birds that fly like wings, but we do. Okay, and then we stop it there. Open your arms very wide. And as you exhale, cross your arms and bend one side. And then again, inhale, reach, extend like you want to push the walls on the side. Exhale, hug yourself and bend other side. And again, inhale, reach, really feel that opening from the chest. Exhale and come and cross your arms. And last time to this other side, open, extend. Exhale and cross. And then let's return to center and come back and closing our arms. So today I found this pretty interesting information about the neck and the head. So well, sometimes we dedicate a lot of the class to the neck work. And so I wanted to bring this information to you. So when we are sitting in a correct alignment, you know, when the neck is, it has a natural curvature, yes, but when the head is above the throat, let's say, the weight of our head is about, I will tell you in kilos, we'll figure out the pounds then, 5 kilos, like what, 9, 10 pounds, yeah. But each little angle that we change in the head alignment forward, it adds up to 27 kilos. So can you imagine the weight and the pressure on the spine each time we sit like this? The head starts, you know, the weight of our head, it grows 5 times at least. So, and that's 5 times more stress for our neck vertebrae. So let's focus more on this. I have exact numbers. I just don't remember them all. They were saying like 15 degrees, it's like whatever amount of kilos, up to 60 degrees. So some people really spend a lot of time like this. In the car, driving, young guys, sorry for that. You know, when we are at the computer in our bed or comfortable chair or couch, we also sitting like this. Sometimes even at the desk, the working desk, if the screen is lower. So all those little details make a huge difference for our spine. So let's sit nice and straight and do some neck work, alignment work. We will imagine that our chin is like resting on the shelf. And we're going to start sliding the chin on the shelf back and forward. And obviously the forward movement is much easier than the back movement. So let us focus more on sending our head back because the forward movement is easy. Inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale, exhale. Breathing through the nose, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And now let's come to the inhalation pose. Breathe normally. Feel compression here on your chin. Bring your chin lower. It's resting on the shelf. And then relax. So none of those was a natural position. The natural position, yes, includes a little curvature on our neck. So we don't walk like this, we don't want to really, neither do we want to walk like this. So we need to find a way to open the amplitude of the movement in both, from the natural to the front, from the natural to the back. Now we're going to explore the same movement in the same arrangement, turning our head to the side. So we're going to turn the head to whatever side you want to begin with. And here we will begin, inhale, push it back, exhale, push it forward. Inhale back, exhale, but you're still turned to that side. Inhale, push it back, exhale, reach to that corner. Inhale, exhale, and feel what it implies for the neck muscles. You might feel that tension on the back of your neck, a little compression on the front of you, of your neck. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, and then return to center. Send your chin to the other side, and let's do the same. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, in, out, in. Very wide range of movement, especially to the back. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, and then let's come back to center, and we will connect from one extreme to the other, from one edge to the other, rhythmically. So inhale, exhale, and here you go at your let's say at your own pace, but kind of faster pace. And so you send your chin from one shoulder to another, exploring how back you can send your head. Inhale, exhale. So if you're moving faster, your breathing will be faster. So that's fine. Just make sure that you exhale same amount of the air as you inhale. And also glue your shoulder blades to the chair. And make sure that they are not joining you in this movement. You really want to isolate this to your neck. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Let's go to this opposite corner and then return to center. And then come back. Good. It should feel just a little warmer by now after the movement. Let's rub our palms. Let's rub the palms. And send your fingers to the neck and rub gently there. Rub gently there. Good. So you want to press your fingers so you create warmth as you rub your skin. Very good. And then let's come back to center. So let's do something else for the neck. And we're going to create a resistance. I'm not sure if we did it in this class, but most likely on the Wednesday class, but we will do it now, so you will see, you will catch it up. We will create a resistance, but not between the palms. I just show that we kind of feel. So one side pushes another side, and they push each other. So that creates that resistance. And the fight or resistance will happen between your head and one of your hands. As we go, I'll tell you exactly how. So you will find a good neutral alignment for your neck, which means the chin goes just slightly in, not too much here, not too much forward. And let us begin with the easiest one. We will place one of our palms, touch the forehead with it. You are not pushing it so the head tilts back. When you inhale, you will create a neutral pushing. So the palm will push your forehead and the forehead will push your palm. Inhale and push. Push, 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 push. Exhale, relax. Could you feel that? Mm-hmm. They were like, I'm stronger. No, I'm stronger and such. One more time. Inhale. Press. Exhale, relax. So here what we do, we don't really do a wide movement at all. We create that
force.
Yeah, we create that force, we create that resistance. So you can feel one side, well maybe this was not the most successful one to feel, but you will feel how one side of your neck is working more than another. So let's do the other palm, we'll do both sides. Again, so just touch it. Aligning the chin perfectly, and then inhale and press. And push, 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 push. Don't let anyone win. Exhale, relax. And one more. Place your palm, inhale, and press. Hold there, hold, hold, hold. And relax. Yeah, good. Okay. So that was... I kind of felt it more on the very back of the neck, not much on the front. So now we will go to the side. One palm will come to your temple. If you wear glasses, just, you know, lift your, or take your glasses off if you're comfortable, or just make sure you're not pressing on the glasses.
Temple.
Lathe, we call it in Russian. So you don't break your glasses. Anyways. So here we go. Elbow will point out. And we are looking straight. And same thing, we will inhale and create that force. And hold and push. And rest. One more. Elbow points out. Inhale and push. Now switch. We're going to push your elbow, point your elbow out. And here we come. Inhale and push. Rest. And rest. And one more. Inhale and press. Hold there. And relax. Good. So we are strengthening the holding muscles around the neck by doing this. This was more, well, I feel it on the back, but in reality, the front muscles work more. Anyways, but we are going to create a similar kind of resistance on the back of our head. And here is the thing. You know, we are familiar, maybe at least visually, with those famous crunches when you lie on the floor and you do this. So the common mistake that people make when they do that is that they pull the neck forward, push the head forward, and that can be dangerous for the neck. And I actually got to hurt my neck one time like this. So we're going to create, if you reach, cross the fingers behind your head, not behind the neck this time, but behind the head. Let me grab my beautiful plastic. If you don't reach, just, you know, separate your fingers, but you still have this, you know, good contact there. And you will not allow your head to be pushed forward. Actually, I would say don't even force your hands at all. Just push the head back. Inhale. Push, 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 push. Hold, 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 hold. Exhale and rest. Let's do two more of those. This is an important one. Inhale, hold and push. And rest. And last time. Inhale. Push and hold. And back. And rest. So those of us who happen to have at least every once in a while, or maybe frequently, any kind of neck-related thing, pinched nerves, sometimes it's hard to turn to one side, or it's just there is generally limitation when you turn to one side, numbness that goes down towards your hands, pain somewhere in your trapezius muscles. I mean, there's so much can be related to the neck problem. So you can do these exercises. Push. Yeah.
What about a sciatica?
Well, this has no influence in sciatica. You would do this just for the head. Oh, you mean, I see what you mean. If neck can affect your sciatica. I wish I knew the answer. It can, but I'm not really sure about that. I'm not really sure. I can research that.
Okay.
I'll be honest. I don't know exactly. But there are a few things you can do. If you need, you can put your glasses back on. There are a few things you can do at home with this. So let's say you're lying on your bed and you're using a pillow under your head. So try to use the softer pillow and you're lying supine and you're trying to press the head, like smash your pillow toward the bed. Inhale and push. I'm just showing, but it's horizontal thing. Exhale, relax. And again, inhale and push. And exhale, relax. Just visualize that. You can do it on your bed. There's another thing you can do, and that is really interesting. But if you have like a normal bed, has a headboard, you will need to turn sideways. So you lie on your bed, and I'll show, I'll be very visual right now. So let's say that this is my bed. So let's say that this is your bed. So you will slide on your bed, so the shoulders are on the edge of your bed. You need to turn other way on your bed because you have headboard there, right? And you will have your head hanging here for a few breaths. And then you will turn to your stomach, and again, shoulders in line, and you will not drop your head. Don't try to lift it, just hold it there. You can turn it to one side and hold it there. It's hanging, you're using your holding muscles. You can turn to the other side and hold it there, and then come back to center and lie normally. So there are a few things we can do at home for our neck, definitely. Okay, so we're going to think on the tip of the nose now and create the infinity sign. So we're going to breathe to one side, exhale to the other, and each of your movements will get wider and wider and wider and wider, and then stop and reverse, go all the way around, wider and wider, and listen to your neck, maybe it's talking to you now. And then come back to center. Very good. Let us take a profound breathing in and blow forward. Really, very powerful. And again, breathe in. And one more. And then come back to center. Good. Okay. After this one, sitting nice and straight, let us do some vigorous shoulder movement, which will also help to improve the blood flow to your neck. Begin with whichever shoulder you want, and that one will do up, down. The same shoulder, inhale up, exhale down. And just make sure that you're sitting straight, so each time when you throw that shoulder down, it doesn't compress your spine. So feel your core holding your spine, and then you can do whatever you want with your shoulder. Switch to the other side. It's a vigorous movement, the breathing is active. And then we will try to keep the same pace, and we will just switch, one other one. Inhale one side, exhale other side. And then relax. And now that we warmed up, we brought a lot of blood to the neck after this movement. Again, align yourself, keep your chin parallel to the floor. You will turn to the left, inhale, head. Turn to the left, inhale, to the right, exhale. Kind of faster pace. Choose your eyes, either closed or open. I feel like 9-10 closed is very comfortable, but you decide. Inhale left, exhale right. And then switch your breathing, inhale right, exhale left. And then come back to center. Let's bring our arms all the way above the head. Touch your palms together. And we're gonna do some more shoulder work here. So basically we inhale, lifting, exhale, kind of bringing them back to the crown. So there is a little trick here. If you need some help, you can cross your thumbs. If you wanna challenge yourself, just glue your palms like this together. But we have a tendency to bring our chin immediately down when we do this. So let's focus on having a good alignment here. Inhale, exhale. And then we are going to alternate exhalation in front of your face, like at the nose height, and then exhalation behind. Now, where is the head? Is it coming forward? Don't let it bend forward. Stay straight, even if it means for you just to bring your hands to the crown. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Try to lock that part of your body, I mean the neck, so it doesn't move. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. By now, you might be hating me already. inhale, exhale, couple of more, inhale, exhale, and last time, and behind your head, come up, and relax, and immediately feel this flushing, the blood, the heat like waves flushing here to your neck, throat, good. Okay, so we're going to spread our feet wide enough. You're still sitting fully on the chair. And you feel your sacrum resting on the back of your chair, but not the upper spine, okay? So let's separate our shoulder blades from the chair. Feel, not feel, have your feet ankles right beneath your knees. So you create a good alignment on your legs as well, safe for your knees. Arms will go to the sides. And we're gonna start warming up lower down the spine. Inhale, reach to one side. But keep your arms in the same line, not like this, but still parallel to the floor. Exhale, other side. Inhale, one side. Exhale, other side. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and then we will switch the breathing. Inhale to this other side, and exhale to the opposite. Inhale. Exhale, do not bend, just reach to the side. Extend leg, remember, what are we reaching there? A $1 million lottery ticket. So you want to go as far to the lottery ticket as possible. Inhale, exhale, last time. Reaching, other side, come back and rest. Now we will start tricking, or I'd say tricking the brake, but challenging our balance. So let us just sort of hook our feet probably at the chair, you know. We are not really holding them off the floor, but do not touch the floor. So there's some support still, the chair supports us. Same thing, find your base. So both buttocks, both sit bones evenly on the chair. And we do not bend, we just extend to the side and then exhale. Let's choose whichever side you want to breathe in, and then the other one will be to exhale. We will play with this movement quite some time and then come back to center. And now we do lift our feet off the floor and do not touch the chair either. So we need to use some of our thighs right now. Inhale, find your sit bones. Don't let any side to come off the chair, even a little bit. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Again, exhale, last time, inhale. And exhale, come back, rest your arms, but extend the legs. Now we only count on part of our hamstrings, and obviously the buttocks. There's no support on the bottom at all. Let's have our arms here, fingers pointing out. We need to use the core muscles to keep the spine straight, and we need to use, these muscles, the hip flexor muscles, to keep the legs off the floor straight. And that's already work. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Try to reach, you still same, badly want that $1 million lottery ticket. So really go to the side. Even though there's no foot support, you still want to extend and make it yours. Exhale, inhale, exhale. One more, inhale, and exhale. Come back, lift. Hold, 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 hold. Exhale and relax. Good. Okay, so now let us do some pelvic tilts, which is also about the alignment. Actually, answering your question a little bit, I just remembered that within a chiropractic science, let's say, or service, there is one particular group of chiropractors, one school of chiropractors, I should say, that work primarily on the neck. So they barely go to the rest of the spine, they adjust the neck, and this is pretty much all they do, because according to that school, the rest of our body can be totally affected by the misalignment of the neck. So following that school's idea, I would say yes, we can misalign our hips and therefore affect the sciatic nerve too. This is pretty much it I could tell you today about it. Okay, so we're going to have our legs spread wide and sit nice and straight, and you do feel the sacrum on the back of your chair. And we're going to start our pelvic tilts right now. So you will push your pelvis forward, and you will feel how the back, the lower back, is imprinted to the chair. And this is your exhale. You need to squeeze your tummy here. And then you inhale and tilt it back and create the arch. Exhale, push it forward, imprint your back to the chair, I mean the lower back. Inhale, arch. Exhale, push. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. And again, exhale, forward. Last time. Back, forward, and back to center. Okay, now let's engage our legs to this. And for those who would like to take it to a little different level, I'm talking about the physical intensity. If you would rather continue on the chair, it's fine. So make sure that your ankles are beneath your knees, hands on your knees, and you're straight, but not all the way, just a little bit forward. Press your hands to the knees, and you come off the chair, but you don't really feel it that much. And let's continue with the movement. Inhale, push your tailbone back. Exhale, forward. Look forward. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. So you're looking straight, and you're working with your pelvis back to inhale, forward to exhale. Back to inhale, forward to exhale. Back and forward. So pubic bone back, pubic bone forward. Last time. Back and forward. And stay there in the middle. And then sit. Good. And let's bring our legs together. Good. Let's scoop forward. And now that we are scooped forward, we're going to work on the, after the previous exercise, we created a little, you know, tension in the muscles here. So with this movement, we want to release that tension. I would say even relax the legs completely and move your legs with your hands and arms. And let your feet kind of rock on the floor too. Good. Okay, and then we stop this movement and we lift one leg, and if you can reach, cross your fingers under your leg, whichever leg you would like to start with. So here is the point. We want to use the leg as a weight to pull our shoulders down.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you relax the leg, don't hold it like this. Cross your fingers and drop your leg on your fingers. And immediately you will feel the weight of your leg pushing the arms and the shoulder down. Okay. So let's work on that hip now. Inhale when you have the space. Exhale, lift the weight of your leg. Bring it into you. But the leg is lazy. The hip is relaxed. The arms and shoulders are working. And again, inhale down. Exhale in. Inhale down. What is your back doing? Is it rounding when you lift the leg? Try to keep it straight. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Last time. Inhale down. Exhale up. Let's relax. Let's, if you need, just move your fingers a little bit. And let's do the same thing on the other leg. So cross your fingers and drop your leg there. And immediately feel that weight. Inhale there. Exhale in. Inhale down. Exhale in. Relax the leg. So there's really no work, no effort on your hip, on your hip flexor, on your quadriceps at all. Last time. Inhale down. Exhale in and down. Again, move your fingers if you need to. This is a good way to bring blood to your joints on the fingers. And again, let's switch. So bring your legs slightly higher now. I would say that 60% of the work is still on your arms and hands and a little bit on the leg, like 40 or so. And let us begin opening and closing. Opening and closing. So when you open the door, you inhale. When you bring it in and close, you exhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now, if you can, maybe even crossing a little bit, but not really necessary. Inhale, bless you. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last time. Inhale. Exhale. And down.
Bless you.
Bless you. In Russia, we say that when somebody tells something and then somebody sneezes at that time, you're saying a truth.
Oh, yeah. My mother used to say that.
You have a thing?
You sneeze at the truth.
Same.
My grandparents were Russian.
Okay, so here we go. We lift the leg halfway, and we will allow the leg work a little, but most of the work will be on the arms. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Does anyone feel stretch on the other side when you bring your leg in? Exhale. Does anyone feel it? So maybe I didn't feel anything like this on the right leg. Now that I grabbed my left one, I totally felt it. Inhale, exhale. So let's welcome our imperfection, our asymmetry. Exhale, last time. Inhale, exhale, and come back. So let's spread our feet, probably the width of the chair. And we will lift the leg, maybe holding it, maybe not. It will be up to you, but we want to swing the foot side to side. Breathe naturally, just inhale and exhale. And it will literally look like you swing it from the knee down. Relax the ankle as well. Let the foot just do, do, do. There, very good. Well, I just found a way to help myself. If I hold my knee like this, the movement is just a little more natural because I want us to loosen up the hip joint. So see if that works for you. Good. And then let's relax the side and hold this opposite one and do the same. Breathe naturally, allow for the air to flow in and out, non-stop. Good. Excellent. So swing the foot side to side. And tell me, where do you think the movement starts? This movement?
The knee.
Hip.
Yeah. It starts on the hip, really. That's true. So let's relax. Because the femur bone is doing tum, 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 and this tum, tum begins on the hip, even though it seems from the knee. And if we have some knee injury and if it hurts, like you have pain, you might feel it on the knee more. But the very beginning of the movement is on the hip. Okay. So maybe you will be very careful today with what we want to do further because of the knee. Whoever else has the knee pain, just be gentle there. Okay, so we're going to now use the right leg and the right hand to hold this underneath. Bring it up. Now, you may hold it like this or like this if it's hard to reach on the bottom. Now, this left hand will try to reach as low your shin as you can. If you reach to the ankle, good. If you reach to the knee, good as well. If you reach slightly below the knee, fine also. Now, the right arm really holds the weight, carries the weight. Now, left hand carefully brings the foot in and relaxes. In and relax. In and relax. In and relax. One more. In. I was looking if we have some straps. Let's relax this side. And we'll do the left side. So left hand holding underneath or on the knee. And the right hand will go as lower to your ankle as you can. Find the leg. Both arms are working hard. The left one is carrying a lot of weight. Lift the ankle and relax. Lift and relax. Lift and relax. Lift. Awesome. And relax. Last time. Lift and relax and down. Okay. So let's allow our hips to rest a little bit. Have those feet a hips distance apart. You're scooped forward. You have your buttocks on the chair, hamstrings off the chair. And we will, again, for those of you who would like to fake coming up, because this is basically what we're going to do, you will have your ankles right underneath your knees. If you would like to actually lift your buttocks off the chair, you will bring your feet slightly under, and that will give you a little better way to do that. Okay, so we all remember how we do that. We hinge from the hips, and we gaze forward. The spine is perfectly straight, and shoulders are down, because we will use the strength of our legs rather than contraction on the shoulders. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale and down. Inhale, slightly up. Exhale. Inhale, slightly up. Exhale down. Okay, let's play with this. Bring your feet just a little bit closer. Still space, but just a little bit closer. Same, if you want to get up, ankles under. If you want to just fake it, you get up, ankles right beneath the knees. Inhale, cool, exhale and rest. We're gazing forward. Inhale from the hips, exhale and forward. Last time, inhale, exhale. Now bring your feet fully together. And your knees will be exact same above your ankles. What that means is that we don't do this, neither do we do this, to protect the knees. And now we glue them together like one. I always forget the name of this Disney thing without legs.
The mermaid.
Mermaids. Without legs. That's what we are. Mermaids right now. I, for some reason, confusing the Cinderella with Cinderella.
They're all princesses, you know?
Well, yeah, they're all princesses in this other one.
One's just wearing more green than the other.
Yeah, okay. There was a little research that they did that all the Disney princesses, if you forget about the hair color and dressing, they have pretty much the same type of face. Okay, so we have our hands near the knees or on the knees. Remember, you will choose if you want to get up or just pretend that. From the hips forward. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, don't lift that high. Low, low, low. Yeah, this is a thing. So listen, this is a little moment that we have to be aware of. Because when the awareness is not there, it's easy to hurt the muscle or to fall when you age. But this is not the case for you yet. But with the 90 years olds that I work, they still think that they are 60. And it's really very easy to fall. Because when we are kids, this is how we get up. But the muscles and joints are working well, and so that's not a problem. We need to catch that little instant of the separation from the chair. 1 inch. And then that. And when we have that strength in that 1 inch of the chair, we can count with the safer getting up when we fully get up. So let's hold, like kind of catch that moment in our attention and don't lift higher. From the hips forward, inhale, hold, exhale, relax. Inhale, hold, exhale, relax. Last one. Inhale, hold, and exhale, relax. So whatever we do in general, in life, sitting, standing, and such, just try to please remember, unless you're sitting in a cross-legged pose, try to remember that the knees need to point in the same direction as the toes. So we don't do this, neither do we do this, so the knee is well aligned. Okay, now we're going to have a comfortable space between the feet. We continue working with this holding muscles. We continue strengthening the hips and all nearby parts for our safety and for our balance. So you will find a space between your feet which is comfortable for you The most comfortable you notice is for you for this. So find that space. Okay, distance between your feet. And now we're going to start challenging more one side than another. And you will need to focus more on your core, because the core as a center of the body will have to work for this other side that will not be working fully. So let me show what I want us to do. Let me show first. So we're gonna fake or fully come up, heel up. And then other heel up. And then we'll come back and sit. And we'll continue increasing the grade of interest of this exercise. So, from the hips, hinge forward, hands somewhere on the knees, looking straight, lift one heel up, switch other heel up, and sit. Again, forward, hinge, one heel up, other heel up, and sit. One more detail that I wanted to tell us, which most of times we neglect, but it's so important for the overall alignment and the health of our knees and ankles, is when you lift your heel, please make sure that the most of the weight is falling on the ball under your big toe. It's the biggest toe, the joint is the strongest, and it was intended to carry more weight. So don't do this, look at my foot, do this. Really be focused on that, because something more interesting is coming. So here we go. We'll do just one time on each side, and then we will move on. Hands on the knees, sitting nice and straight. Hinge from your hips, looking straight. Inhale, lift one heel, switch. Other heel, and down. And maybe till now, we didn't really realize how important the core needs to be here. And for this next time, for this next exercise, we might notice how important the core is. This next exercise is not easy, so please don't feel, you know, bad if it doesn't work. But we want to be able to lift both heels and down, at least a tiny bit at the same time. We will do it, lift, down, and then you will sit, okay? Okay, so if you feel like that would be just too risky, please do one after another as an option, or do both but sitting and faking that you're coming up, okay? Here we go, hinge from the hips, inhale, lift, both heels look straight, and down, stay, and both heels, and down, and sit. Good. No way, honey. Okay. It's fine. Let's do it again. Remember the knees.
One day I'll get off the chair.
Uh-huh.
One day I'll get off the chair. But I'm consistently not doing it.
I see you tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. So when we do this, lifting both heels, it's very shaky on the knees. Please avoid doing this. Keep the knees spread, okay? Okay, let's do it one more time. Here we go, hinge from the hips, hands on the knees. Inhale, lift, heels up, heels down, look straight, heels up, heels down, and sit. And it's not that we really get out of the chair like this, right? We don't really lift our heels. But the muscles that are engaged in that little instant just create and give you more support. There is a posture in yoga when we have to, whatever you do with your hands, but you stay like this and you lift your heels and you work up to down and then you lift up and then and my knees are so it just gives you more proprioception, more perception of your own balance. And that engages a lot more of the muscle work and awareness also. Okay, so let's shake it. Let's shake our knees. Very good. Okay. Now, I want us to explore a little more, but With the same, you know, initial exercise, you see we did this, right, a few minutes ago? So I would like us to work doing same movement, but really on one foot. Again, you either, you know, fake, pretend that you come up, but faking means you still force your muscles and push your feet down, or you can actually come up, you know, with me. So we're going to begin having the right leg over. Now, if this is no way, you can cross from the shin on the ankle, okay? Feel free to do that, but you still will try to use just that base leg and foot, okay? Here we go. You need to center this base foot. It's only one now, so bring it right somewhere in the middle. And if you look at your knee, you will see it's right above the foot. It's not anywhere to the side. Okay, so we're gonna count on that base side. And I, of course, begin with the comfortable side, so I'm gonna challenge myself a little bit. Anyway, the alignment is good, check it. Have your hands on your upper knee. Well, in your case, honey, it's gonna be just on your thigh, it's fine. Okay, the base foot is fully on the floor, and it will be fully on the floor for now. Hands on your knee, come forward from your hips, look straight, inhale, maybe come up, exhale and sit. That is beautiful. We try to. You see, if you were looking at me, it took me a little bit to find balance also. I didn't come up immediately. So it's fine. Like I said, please, let's celebrate what we've got today. Okay, hinge from your hips, look straight. Inhale, maybe come up. Exhale and down. Whether we came up or not, the base foot, if you notice, was doing this, and it's fine. Let's allow it adjust those tiny bones, tiny muscles and ligaments and such. They were trying to keep the foot as the only base we had. Switch. Now let's see my stronger side. Okay, so align this base foot, knee above the foot. And here we go, hold to this knee, straighten yourself, hinge from your hips, inhale, and maybe come up. Keep moving. Exhale and down. So we are keeping that awareness. This foot is fully, put your knee right above your foot because you will mess up the knee and I don't really want you to do that. So know this, guys, really, it's really dangerous for the knee. So find that alignment. Don't go anywhere yet.
Can I move your foot slightly to here?
Uh-huh, yeah, at least like this. Yeah, because we want that knee to be safe. And now, are we still working on that same side? Okay, straighten, hinge from the hips, inhale, exhale, good. Switch again. Now, if the knee is an issue, you can either align it perfectly and try, or just fake that you come up, because we really want to make sure that we don't push beyond the pain zone, pain line. Okay, straighten, hinge forward, look forward, inhale, exhale. No hands, whoop, cover it. Divine feminine, we have to celebrate it since only girls are here. Huh? Okay, from your hip, inhale, exhale, no hands. Whoop. Again, whoop. Again, whoop. Inhale, down, switch. Inhale, down, switch. Inhale, knee, my God. Switch, last time. Inhale, down and relax. Good. So just by playing with this, we can get a very full body workout. So let's say thank you to our legs and knees. And just go up and down and rub your legs or tap on them. Good. Yeah, tapping is also very good. You can choose one leg at a time and just go on both sides. And then switch to the other side, other leg. Very good. And then come back to center. So we did a lot of work for the balance today, for the alignment and balance, and we could just notice how important the alignment is for any kind of physical health, but especially when we talk about balance. Because if the foot is aligned incorrectly and we walk pressing on the incorrect side, we affect all the way up to the ankle, to the knee, to the hip, and so on. So let us be just more aware in our regular basis when we come up, but we're not gonna come up now sitting, but do the same exercise of awareness when you do come up. So sit, but do not lean back though. And close your eyes, and do not move anything, any muscle, but focus your attention on the very soles of your feet. So try not to, do not adjust anything now, just notice. And notice for yourself, now without the weight of your entire body, where on the sole of your foot is the biggest impact, let's say. If it's on the ball under your big toe or somewhere off that line towards the edge. So try to bring that, align that foot and the ankle, create an arch in your foot, especially for those of us who have not very pronounced arch. So now that you sit, we will use the muscles of our feet to tighten there and create that arch. So tighten the sole of your foot, create that arch, and press more on the ball under your big toe. This little exercise of alignment and awareness can save us from many, many fallings and knee pains and hip pains and such. When you stand up and you have a little second, reconnect, create that arch, tightening your muscles, and pushing a little more on the ball under your big toes. Good. And now relax your foot, your feet, both feet. Now that your eyes are closed, let us cross our fingers, Venus lock, and if you're sitting all the way back, you will scoop forward. If you're sitting all the way forward, you will scoop back. So we're going to scoot back and forward, one buttock at a time. Keep your eyes closed. Use your muscles to help you to keep balance and not your visual hooks. So basically, you're scooping yourself back and forward, one buttock after another. Eyes are closed. So do it. Probably a couple of more times, back and forward, back and forward. Good. Nice. And then scoop all the way back so you feel your sacrum resting and you can relax and uncross your fingers, relax your feet, lean back fully. Find your chin, where is it now? So as we did at the very beginning of the class, now at the end of the class, let's bring awareness to the neck alignment as well. And always keeping in mind that our physical alignment of our body parts translates to our emotional alignment as well. How we can focus our mind, so mental alignment is also depending. They all depend on one another. So keeping your physical body in alignment makes it easier for the emotional and mental balance as well. We're going to connect our palms at the heart in the prayer pose. And now just take a little inventory, scan your body with your awareness, and thank your body for the effort today. And I can't stop being amazed of how we can use the chair to help us to strengthen the body rather than just to sit on it. Many, many thousands of years ago, it was invented in China. So thanks, Chinese people, for this tool. Let's take a deep breath in, lifting our arms above the head. Extend and maybe slightly arch. And then exhale and bring your prayer palms back to your heart. And we will do the stretch again now. Inhale, lift your arms. Expose your chest forward, arch back. And then exhale, palms touching again at your heart. And then you open your eyes whenever you're comfortable. And we are done for today. Thank you so much. So make sure that you sign on the back, please, for me.